Hey guys, it's me, that cringy kid next door. This is the part two of my How I Do GFX. So, yeah, I'm gonna be teaching y'all what I do and how I do it. This is the second part, so this is gonna be the Cinema 4D tutorial when I did the Photoshop before. And I'll be telling you the rigs that I use. Excuse me. And, yeah, so let's get started. So first off, I'm already going to say that I use the FMR 5.0 Remix Edit, which is free. So first of all, I'm just going to put my skin on there. Well, not my skin, but the client's skin. I'm going to basically do his request while I do this. But, I'm just going to go turn off the eyes. And everything. Okay. So, we're already starting off to this, thing. So, right now, this thing can have subdivisions, and we don't want that. So, for things like this, you scroll down all the way to the bottom, and then you see subdivisions. This will be on, just to say to you, you don't want these on, otherwise it will lag, and you will have a harder time of speed. So, first off, let's already just start off on what to extrude, how to extrude it, and why. So, we're going to start off with the head, because that's what I would be doing here. So first off, you want to go into here, and with the layers, and then you go here into 5.0 body and 5.0 joints. These will be locked. Click these locks, and then they'll unlock so that you can edit this mesh head or something. So, once you have this, what you're going to do is go into head, this head, going to scroll down and go into head data, so right here. Now this will come in handy for later, but right now we're going to extrude the head. So right here, you'll see that it gets slightly slanted. Don't worry, this means nothing. It is just trying to fit into the subdivision. So just clicking this button right here, and hitting live selection, we'll just make it go back. So, since this thing has a very simple skin, I am going to do this with just one layer. So, when extruding and you've made your selection, what you do is you hold shift if you're going to select again and control if you're going to deselect. Let's get to the warm-ups. But when you're done, you press D, set the maximum angle to 91, and then you set the offset to whatever you want. I am going to do 3, just because. So I'm going to do that for this ear too. So now here's the little tip. Things that come in like clothes or something, this is like, do this either on 1 or on 2, depending on what you want it to be. I will most of the time make it 2, just so that it stands out more. But 1 can also, so that little, you know, that little, it can give that little addition of cleanness. So, we already have the head done, but now, we're going to do the head. So, we're going to get this head out. Looks the same as the hat. Going to extrude this. Right here. I'm going to make this 2. This will be 4. And this will be 3. So, I want to make things that are supposed to stick out more, stick out more. Like, things like this pig snout, which is basically supposed to be on his skin, that is supposed to be sticking out just a bit more, just so that I can get the idea that, you know, it's like, it is a pig and it does need a big snout. So, here's the thing that many people don't do. When you're doing this, you'll realize that sometimes the hat is like way too big for the head. So just get the sizing tool and shrink that down so that it fits, you know, not perfectly, but nicely. So now we're going to move on to the arms, which is what I do next. So, first of all, I already want to point out that when doing the arms, I start by just going around the entire thing if they have a visible hand. If they do not have a visible hand, do not do anything there. Here's another tip. People that have this type of thing on the back of their skin, it is also quite weird because that is supposed to mean that it was a 3-pixel wide arm skin thing. And when you're rendering that out, just try not to show that as much as you can. I said as much as you can't because if I say can, that just means you're trying to show it. So, yeah. So when you get down to the bottom, you want to make sure that you extrude it by either by 1 or by 2. If you forget where some of the pixels are, like I just did, if you find the crease in the middle of the arm, get that pixel and go around that with another 1-pixel wide extrusion. So then, once you're done with that, this part right here is always weird, so just remember, don't show that. And let's do the same thing for the other arm. So just extrude. Now, this might take a little while, and might take a bit longer than my Photoshop tutorial. This is just because it is harder to do tutorials that include, like, you know, like the modeling part, but things that are like just showing how you do it, or how some people would do it, that's easier. But since there's so many styles and extruding, it might take longer. So I might just skip the extruding if it takes me too long. How long is this video? Yeah, this thing's already 7 minutes long. So yeah, I gotta hurry up with this. So now, once you're done, there's this thing on this Revix edit that allows for a jacket. Also, you can close out this type thing. So when you go down, you'll find this thing, or you can just click this thing on here, this jacket. You can press on, and then go into edit, put the skin that you're using on there. Yes. And just press yes. So then, right here, this thing will appear, and this will look weird for a minute because, of course, you don't want it like that. But we're going to do is delete all the parts that we don't want on here. So especially like the parts like the skin and stuff, we don't want that. Also make sure you have a right sort of idea of where you want to go with this, because you can make it look all snazzy and stuff, but just make sure that you have a good enough shape so that it doesn't just look all funky. Because doing something like that just looks like some sort of weird slant, that's okay, and doing this with a scarf is also okay, but doing it in like this way of just something that includes, like, let's say, let's say you had like one strand right here, and you just deleted that, that would look weird. But once again, you can just do whatever you want with this. This is just my anyway. So remember, just delete what you don't want. So then you have that. And then on places that like that have skin, like I said before, you just want to delete those. So I'm gonna get to that in just a second before I get rid of all of this. And okay. So we've already deleted the bottom, so now we can just delete this part right here. Skin, and then you don't want the skin. So now we go out of this mode, and then we set this back to normal mode so that it's all extruded and whatnot. Then we move this jacket right here to be at 0, I believe. That's another. Okay. Well, this, we just move this over here. And you can move it to like whatever spot, but typically about 260 is about where it should be. So I'm just gonna set it to 260 right there. And if that still doesn't look right, then just mess around with it. And okay, so maybe about 259. Just tamper around with it until you don't see the other side of the thing. And then, okay, so we got it. So now, the legs, I typically extrude these just by what I see. So like right here, we have no shoes, so I'm just going to do the thing like with the rims, and then that's it for the legs. You can do the shoes even if it doesn't look like they have any, but I preferably don't do that just so that people don't get confused or like, but yeah, they have no shoes. What do you mean? So I just don't do that just for the fact that, it's... Also, while I'm doing this, I just want to apologize that I don't do speed arts. I don't know how to... my editor just doesn't do that, so I'm sorry. Okay, so after that tiny little conversation, just move everything back by selecting the move tool and just putting it back at zero. If your extrusion went in so far that the arm looks like it is intersecting to the body, like this, with a little outline going inside, you can move it out like about 1.5 pixels, but that's just optional. Now for the head, if you have any like extruded hair on the bottom, move it up about 1 pixel just so that the hair on the bottom doesn't look like it's poking through. So, now that we have this, we have our little render dude set up. So I'm just gonna move everything back to its original position. And okay, so here we are at phase two. We are going to be doing the positioning. So, So we're going to start off by the positioning. So let's say you want your character to duck down or something. I don't want mine to duck down, but I am going to do something similar to that. I am going to angle his foot. You don't have to angle their feet, but you can if you want to. You always want to tilt their body though. And you see, this is not a good pose so far, but once you find out what you really want to do with it, like I just have, what you do is you bend the arm, typically, because straight arms can just look weird at times, so that's why I don't do it. But now, you can get this arm. See, these arms can be relatively stiff if you want them to be. I still don't recommend it, just so that... I mean, yeah, look, let's say they're doing some sort of boot shooting thing. But, yeah. So, now here's another tip. Wherever their body is facing, you kind of want them to face the other way. Now, here's a little camera angle tip. So, get into the view and click on the camera. You'll go down here and it says field of view horizontal. You can do somewhere like 70 to 80. I wouldn't recommend any higher than that. But you can get as close to you want as it. But I wouldn't recommend getting too close. Otherwise you can't see anything that's going on and it just looks weird. So typically you don't want to have your characters spread out too much. But if you get it into a pose where it's like, it kind of fills up the render screen, you're good. Now, you can mess with the vertical, but I don't typically do that. I just... So, basically, what you do is, this is where all the rigs come in. So, you can see right here also that this arm is still showing like that blank spot. Curse you, 3 pixel white skin. But just tilt the arm so that it doesn't look like it's doing that. Or not doing that, I should probably say. And just move around with the camera for a little bit. And then if you see any flaws that you might capture in the rendering, just change that. Okay, so now we're going to get into the rigging. So this is the camera angle that we're going to use. And so let's go into... Oh yeah, quick note before I get into the rigging. You see this jacket right here? Yes, this one. Typically, once you've done this, you kind of maybe just want to edit it a little bit, just so that it doesn't look like it's just weird. So, go into your pixel tool, click on it. Well, actually, there we go. Get to your pixel tool, go into your brush, make the strength 50, the radius 50, and let's go. So, now what you can do is stretch this over to where you think it should be. Just make sure that it gets over like the places where like you think the wind would be blowing it. Also, if it falls behind the regular jacket or like let's say chest, there we go. Then you might want to just bring it forward so that it doesn't just like intersect or dissect. Still, now just make sure that like the top doesn't go out like I just accidentally did. So just like, if you accidentally did that, it's no biggie, just move that back and move that. Also make sure that you just like move the edges of this jacket very well, otherwise it'll just move. Okay, cool. So now we have this jacket. Now, there's also things that you can do with like decreasing the pixel size and what you're doing, but I don't typically do that. I'll only do it if it becomes a necessity. So when you get out of this view, look at what you think you might want to capture. So you can already see that we're taking up some more space in the render, which is what you want. So let's set this back to normal, and we're good. So, now once you have this, this is where the rigging comes in. So I've already put in all my rigs. I have the bow rig edit by Reapy. I have the Minecraft pack. I don't know where it comes from. I have the Ninja Pack by Noi, and I have the Rope Rig by GreatFX, and I have the Ultimate Paradox Pack V4, which is a bunch of swords. So I'm just gonna start off by getting this Rope Rig, which is what you want. Now get out of the camera angle for this, just so that, like, let's say there was this one flaw that you didn't see, and you just want to like make sure that you can see it. You want to get that. Okay, so. You guys can download these. I don't really have the download links, but if you can look them up, you can probably download them. So we're just going to try and fill up as much of this render as we can. So making sure that like you attach things to things like the, like this rope that we're going to do, making sure that you attach things can also help fill up the render. And you'll see why I want to fill up the render really badly. See, filling up the render can help improve like visual performance. I know that sounds like glasses reviews, but I'm really telling the truth. You want there to be a lot in your render, but not so much that no one can tell what's going on. You know what I'm saying? We're just like mess around with where everything goes. So like this rope rig, this is the first time I've actually used this. But just moving it around randomly, you could probably find out where it would go. So looking at this camera angle, you probably don't want that to go through there. So if you pull this out a bit, you just want that to outline, you know, so that it goes out. So then this part right here, even though it's not part of this first rope, you just want to make sure that it goes nicely. And here's the thing, if you notice anything wrong with the little position in here, just pull it out a bit. It doesn't really matter. Okay, so now that we have these very large ropes, not gonna lie, so now that you have these large ropes, you can just, I would say, probably just start attaching things either. So like let's say but here's the thing, like let's say you don't want to use this rig, like you just don't feel like it fits in, well then you can just delete it. But I personally think it is kind of fitting with the render. Not really, but it's just for the tutorial. So now what we're going to do is go into our swords, and you typically want to have at least 4 swords per or to render. Now, I would recommend that only for like one render if you're doing a banner. Now, here's another tip. Not many people add two swords in one hand, but it is highly recommended that you do that just so that you know, like, you can do that to make it more pizzazz like. So, here's another thing some people don't do. What you do is you get these swords together. So, like, I'm just gonna move this back to 0, 0. Okay, so now that we have these two swords together, I want these swords to go into the same hand at almost the same angle, but just slightly different with different angles and different positions. Now, bending swords is a very good idea, but sometimes it can, like, look weird. So that's why I got an automatically bending sword rig. Well, not automatically, but, like, it has a setting that you can do. Okay, so now that we have the two swords in, you know, like, almost the same spot, which is where we want them, we can check to see if it looks weird. So, you typically want to shrink the swords too, just to like make sure it fits inside the render. Also make sure it's in their hand. But don't make it so far into their hand like that, otherwise they'll get twisted. Make sure to tilt it at the right angle, so that it looks like it's actually, you know, in their hand, not just being thrown around by the natural forces of render gravity. And just move this back. Now you see, in my Photoshop tutorial, you'll see why I added two swords. That is the part one, this is the part two, like I said before. So, you will find why. Okay, so let's just move this sword back a bit. And there we go. So, just move around the sword as much as you want. And press go. So, the reason why I got a bow rig is not so that he would shoot it, but so that he can wrap it around himself. Now, not many people do this either, but I found that you could do this when I was looking for some GFX. I was like, dang, man, that's pretty good. I'm going to try that. I tried it, and man, it worked. Fresh. So, I'm just going to move this around. You see, you can already see that it's kind of hard to tell what's happening, but we're trying to make sure that you can at least tell what's going on in the front of the render. But when you watch my Photoshop tutorial, you'll see that, like, we're just trying to, you know, make things dark. And making things dark also helps add some more shadowing detail. And it also can hide those mistakes in the rendering that you just couldn't catch when you were rendering it. So here's the little thing. The reason why I love using this rig is because I can pull back its string as much as I possibly please, and it'll take a while before it starts looking weird. Now, yes, it may look weird to you, but as long as you can see the string and bow, you just wanna make sure that it's all good. Now, I know it may not seem very fancy right now, but looking right here and seeing that bow, just want to make sure that you get a lot of the bow figure. So, like, let's say you see that bow over there, just wrap the string around, you know? You can put it in their hand or around their hand. I am just personally, for this tutorial, going to put it underneath their hand. Just because, you know, why not? I'm also going to wrap it around this sword, which is another good idea that I just thought of. Maybe it's not the best idea, but it's a good idea. So, there we go. So, we've already gotten quite a few things down, and I'm going to get out my other rig, which is called the Ninja Pack. And here we already have like many things that we can use, and this man actually fits perfectly with this, because he is actually in a ninja skin. So, what we are going to do is get a lot of these ninja tools, and we are just going to spin them around and make them look like just random projectiles coming out of nowhere. Doing this can help with the effect that they're moving And I didn't cover this in my Photoshop tutorial, but whenever you have like some random projectile, you want to copy it and paste it, and then give it a motion blur, and that'll just help it a lot. Now, instead of having to like go into your rig thing and just adding these again, you could just, you know, just do Control C, Control V. That's what I do. And make sure that you can angle them differently sometimes, because angling them differently also helps. So I'd say we're finished with those. Now we can get some other tools. I personally like this staff, so I like to put at least two of these on them per render. You don't have to do this, and you don't have to do or use any of these rigs. I'm just personally using them because I like them. So once you have positioned all of your things in there, what you can do is, once you like the render, if you don't want anything to look like all random, just connect the objects that you think should go together, just so that, you know, it's like, it all just works together. So just make sure that nothing really changes when you mix all of them together. So now, select all of them by dragging your mouse across, Control C, and then minimize this. And I hear there's a free version of Monday's Lightroom V3, but I just got it. So I'm going to open this up, Control V, yes, go into this. Go into camera view, and you'll notice that when opening multiple Lightrooms, or when opening Lightrooms, sometimes the camera will zoom in, and it will look like the FOV has changed. Just like scoot it out a bit more, and then you might want to re-angle it sometimes. You know, it just gives it that better look. So once you've angled it to a better idea on your part, go into render settings. I would say keep it at 1920 by 1080. This thing already has the thing set up. So then, scoot out again, and render. So, the thing will start rendering, but I'll show you the final render once it's done, and then that'll be the end of the video. So I'll see you guys in just a second. See ya. Okay guys, so this was the final render. If you did find this video helpful, please make sure to drop a like down below and subscribe if you are new. You don't have to if you don't want to, but I mean, it's nice. Okay, but hope you did get at least some help with this. If you don't like what I did, then just don't follow the instructions, I'm sorry. But see you guys maybe tomorrow or next week, I don't know. But see ya.
Please make sure to like and subscribe, okay, see ya.